I feel like I'm an Indian, and I'm sending my warriors out to get a scalp, and they're going to get a scalp of Renus Israel today. We've got the scalp of Johan Cruyff. I want to get the scalp of Renus Israel. It'll be a difficult game because the way the situation is now, Jan, they've played badly until now, Feyenoord, but they've still got 9 points, and you've got to be very, very careful because our players might think, you know, we're more informed than they are, and that could be dangerous. You've got to be very careful against Feyenoord. It's a derby game, it's a Rotterdam game, it's a Liverpool-Everton game, and that's why I've warned the players to be very, very careful in everything, to look at every second. Don't be afraid, but, you know, be assured that you know what you're doing.
You think it's easier to beat Feyenoord than to beat Ajax?
Well, Ajax is a better team, you know, on the whole, but Feyenoord are physical strong, and sometimes we can get into trouble with a physical strong team.
Okay, but we can call you now winner to you.
I hope so, I hope so, I hope very much. I hope we can sing after the game. Yeah.
Okay, see you.
Thank you.
Kea Molenaar from Feyenoord. Kea, what do you think about the pitch today?
A lot better than in Rotterdam.
Yeah,
the Kuip, that's sure. But that's not so difficult to make it better than in the Kuip because it's terrible out there.
Okay, but you think it's easy to play on or not?
It's easier to play than in the Kuip, and that's also what Hans Kreis said last Friday. I saw him on TV, and what he said was right about the Dutch national team. It's very difficult to play on a pitch like that, especially when you need to play with a lot of talent, with a lot of technique.
Yeah.
And every time you get the ball, you have to stop it first before you can play it. I think on this pitch it's possible to play it at once.
It's a great match, always, Feyenoord against Sparta. You're both on top now in the competition, so you don't think this pitch is too bad to play on, even for Feyenoord or for Sparta?
No.
What do you think about the result?
No idea. No idea. It always depends on who has the form of the day, who has the shape. That's, you never can say what the score is going to be.
Mario Ben is not injured anymore.
Not anymore.
You have to work for him, and he has to score the goal.
I hope so.
Okay, can you see you?
Bye.
Hi, Dave Mitchell. Welcome here on Sky. A big match. You never played against Sparta in your career. What do you expect? One, two yellow cards, a red card, or you are used to the Dutch referees now?
No, I'm used to them. You know, it was my first day when I played against William II, and maybe I was a bit out of order, but I was very surprised when I got the red card. And today against Sparta it's going to be very tough because I know Barry Hughes will have them fired up, and that obviously they beat Ajax here, and they're going to be tough because it's always a hard game, it's a local derby, and I just hope they can get a couple of points.
You're used to the Dutch competition now?
Yeah, it's, you know, I've had a very bad start, you know, not as nice as I would like, but, you know, I've just got to buckle down and hopefully things will start coming for me.
Okay, that's great. See you in the match.
Okay, then.
Okay, Dave, bye.
Bye.
Well, and this is it, in a very rainy Rotterdam stadium, the match between Sparta and Feyenoord. So let's go to Martin Tyler.
Thanks, Jan. The wet afternoon can't dampen the excitement here in the Sparta Stadium. Sparta's excellent and surprising start to the season, giving an extra edge to the old rivalry. These are the previous results in recent seasons. A double there for Feyenoord over Sparta in 85-86. And as we look at 86-87, again, two wins for Feyenoord. So what can Sparta do to change that? They really are in the form to do it. But they did lose last week, their first defeat of the season, to VVV. They make one change. Henk van Steij comes in place of Andriessen. Jule Ellemann, 7 goals in 6 games so far. And Ronald Lenkeke looking to add to his tally of 4 to celebrate his 27th birthday tomorrow. Sparta, I'm sure, will be highly motivated by Barry Hughes. Ricardo de Jong continues to deputise in the final goal for the injured Jop Hiele. Defender Jack Frost played for Holland against Belgium in midweek. The one new signing this season, you've just met him, the Australian World Cup striker Dave Mitchell, whose previous club was Eintracht Frankfurt in West Germany. And in midfield there, Mario Bain, capable of being a match winner. The referee is Jan Kaiser. As I say, it's very damp underfoot indeed. Sparta defending the goal to the right in the first half. It's going to be a test of strength and balance. Strength of mind as well, as I'm sure Barry Hughes appreciates. Well won by Riederhoff. There's a good crowd, but a lot of them seeking protection from the rain. And I'm sure it would have been even bigger on a fine afternoon. And hit first time and inches away, with Lenkeik showing his pedigree. It was a difficult volley, the ball almost arrived behind him. And a misjudgment here by De Hooy. Hoffman, goal! René Hoffman kept his balance well, but De Hooy betraying his inexperience, really. It was an ill-advised charge out. The ball skipped past him, and Hoffman followed in and punished the error. Heus, Elstrup, and Feyenoord now able to conduct the tempo of the game. Prost. Great save by De Hooy this time from Mitchell, and Hoffman came in on the rebound. Could easily have been two, but the goalkeeper saved Sparta that time and repaid some of the debt he owed to his teammates. Rinus Israel, the Feyenoord coach. Eleman. And Lenkeik wanted a little bit too long, and then brings down Ruud Heos. Well, Feyenoord stopped expecting the free kick. And both sides are angry with the referee at the moment. Jan Kaiser, vastly experienced official. Farense having his say. These two sides with virtually identical records at the start of the game. This was the incident. Lenkeik, who was dwelling on the ball a little bit too long. Ferenc, Elstrup, a powerful runner, and Van der Berg struggling to stay with him. Mario Bain just lost his bearings but got back, and Molinar, plenty of sting in the shot from Kehe Molinar. Good start this by Feyenoord, boosted by the early goal from Hoffman. The cut. The slower the build-up from Sparta, the easier it is for Feyenoord to get their numbers behind the ball, but Eleman came off his man well and has won the free kick. It was quick thinking by the young starlet at Sparta. Eddie Riederhoff is the Sparta captain. Knell with the throw. Might break for him again after the work from Eleman. Molinar doing the defending. Well, they are backing off Riederhoff. Tighter corner for him now. And it looked out from here, and everyone was appealing for Feyenoord, and that could have been costly. The flag stayed down. Every indication that this game is going to be in keeping with the tradition of the Rotterdam derby. Heyward. One problem on this pitch is it is hard to switch the ball quickly, and Lars Elstrup there was caught in possession. Sparta enjoying a spell of pressure at the moment. It's the ideal cross for somebody like Dave Mitchell to meet, but Sparta really don't have that type of central striker. Back from Beinstakers. Feyenoord have away record this season, two wins and a draw. Their only defeat so far has been at home to Pek Zwolle. And when Mario Bain is on song, they take some stopping, home or away. It's never quite easy to predict his moods though, but he's capable of extravagant free kicks. This time happy to roll it short for Molinar. Return pass didn't come his way. But it was a bruising challenge initially on Bain. Feyenoord using the long ball, and Mitchell must make it 2-0. Dave Mitchell, who really didn't have a proper pre-season in terms of training because he wasn't sure which club he was going to sign for, is catching up in the fitness sense now. A goal or two would help, but a miscue then when faced with Dafoe and a great chance. Hoffman with the corner. Molinar. Dafoe grabs onto a greasy ball well. He's only 20 years old and is learning in the limelight, really. One sharp lesson for him in this game already, but that was good work from the youngster. Canel is only 19. Sparta building from their own youth policy. Feyenoord really in a different bracket when it comes to financial resources, although they've rather let PSV and Ajax grow away from them in that sense over the last couple of seasons. You have to go back to 1984 to find the last time Feyenoord won the title. Mitchell trying to hold it up. Molinar running out of room. He's a good influence, Kehe Molinar, on this side. Man. The Feinstakers staying close to him, but the advantage played, taken on by Van Stey. Van der Berg. Jan Kaiser had a good look. The tackle on Berkling by Van Herpen. Mitchell is wholehearted. Hoffman, Elstrup, Spain. Well, Molinar maybe called for the ball but didn't want to shoot, and then Lotte van Herpen went down. A lot of players involved for Feyenoord in that attack. Never quite did any one of them set himself for a shot to finish it off. Did sell their leading scorer from last season, Simon Tahamata, who's gone back to Belgium. Well, after a lot of cooing and frying here, the referee has made his point. And to the disappointment of the Sparta fans, it's a free kick to Feyenoord. It'll be taken by Hoffman. Twisted well by the Hoy. Now, went in bravely. So too did Alemán. Riederhoff and Van der Berg. And the Kant was a little slow. But Sparta, having conceded a goal in the 10th minute of the game, understandably a little slow to pick up their rhythm. They've won all their previous three home games this season. They've scored 12 goals in doing so, and again it's Berkling who's fouled. Riederhoff. Some room here for Hale. And he didn't really make the most of it. Feyenoord have won away to Willem II, the match in which Dave Mitchell was sent off. They've won away at Haarlem and drawn in Alkmaar against AZ. Berkling has been the target of some attempted long passes. Hoffman, who's wandered the width of the field and apart from his goal has shown some imaginative touches. Molinar. Finals continue to look threatening, and it's Elstrup who finds himself on the right, and De Gooi and the crossbar keeping it out from Hoffman. Right on half time, Hoffman with one goal, nearly had two. Welcome back to the Vangen Stadium in Rotterdam. A scoreline that doesn't quite tell the whole story of a vibrant first 45 minutes. But René Hoffman, who is a player that can drift in and out of a match, has again made a telling contribution. Here's Jack Frost. Bain. That was good covering. With Bain always threatening to find the pass that will unlock a defence. Van der Berg, no way through Van Herpen. Here's Hoffman, a threat again. René Hoffman for Feyenoord. Oh, and Dave Mitchell had the goal beckoning again. It was just the sort of cross that he thrives on. Delightfully delivered by Hoffman. Almost a present of the goal. But Dokoi kept it out, even though Mitchell connected well. Shot in it from Van Herpen, and in these conditions well worth testing out the goalkeeper from distance. Pete De Kamp, Jan Olderikering. Sparta have been chasing the game from 9 minutes into it. Olderikering again. Canal, Feyenoord funneling back. Weinsteker is still sticking to Ellemann, and Hale's finding himself in the right back position. But Lenkeik finds a free kick given against him. Mitchell to compete for, and Hoffman had read it well. Always worth another forward going beyond the target player for just that type of episode. But here's Henk van Steij for Sparta. Olderikering, van Steij again, and Parenza trying to get a foot in and failing. Van der Berg. Now it's all being played again in front of Feyenoord and their defenders. Sparta looking really for something with a sharper edge to it in their attacking play. And maybe now Olderikering can provide it with the cross. Lenkeik's shot was blocked after Ellemann had had the miscue, and now is it going to be the equaliser? Surely no. A great save by Trost after Feyenoord had got into a terrible tangle, and the post and Jack Trost to the rescue. And Sparta lifting the tempo, Van Steij just wide, lurking on the edge of the area here. Feyenoord going to be able to keep the upper hand over their closest rivals that they've shown in recent seasons. Dokoi particularly anxious to see his side get something from this game after his mistake acted as such an encouraging start to Feyenoord. Been a much better second half so far for Sparta. Van der Berg. Ellemann. Snell trying to keep the pressure on. And to do that he's got to get past Molinar. Although Molinar rather holding off him and letting Canal find Van der Berg. That's got to be a free kick. Once again, Benny Weinsteker's letting Ellemann know he's there. And Weinsteker's resuming his job, but it's the end of the day for Bain as André Hoekstra takes over from him. Alamant. Van Stey. And the whistle's gone. Player in the middle had run offside. Maybe it was Berkling. At the moment Van Stey shot, the flag went up. And Feyenoord at the moment reduced to giving away free kicks. Down goes Lenkeek. Always an indication of increasing pressure when defenders have to resort to more desperate means. Jan Keizer waving the three-man wall back. Elleman. Well, Hoekstra could have let it go, but he wasn't to know that. Elleman at the moment involved in all the set plays. Vanderberg jumping with Hoekstra, and it was the final substitute who got there first. Here's Riederhoff and Cannell getting in each other's way in their anxiety, and Hoffman leading the counter-attack with Hoekstra. Feinberg covered well, but has now presented the ball back to Hoekstra. Barense. Hoffman. The pace of the match has never slackened, and here's Benny Weinsteker's. Well worth watching in the wet. Van der Berg. Riederhoff. Now made up a lot of ground and then may be damaged in the challenge by Trost. No time for concern from the culprit. He's got to keep an eye on Jop Berkling in the middle. Elleman waiting right on the edge. Should the ball be cleared in his direction? And it has. You do sense that Feyenoord might make something on the break. More and more players committed forward for Sparta. But Peos couldn't find Hoffman or Elstrup, who'd made a lot of ground. Hoffman. Van Stey. Chased by Barense. Elleman. Looks promising for Sparta again. Vanderberg. Back from Cannell. Problem for Kehe Molinar, and it's Kenneth Moncal who will be the substitute. Mitchell guilty of jumping in. Feyenoord with both substitutes on now. Peos with some intricate juggling. Sparta had scored more goals than Feyenoord at the outset from their opening six games. 17 goals for Sparta, 12 for Feyenoord. but the 13th of Feyenoord's season might be enough to lift Feyenoord over their great rivals. De Kant. Older Riekerink. It's more of a containing policy now for the visitors, and they're grateful there for a free kick as Heos was impeded. Parense making Riederhof chase him and buying a little bit more time for Feyenoord. Help from Elstrup. Hoekstra, Elstrup again, Mitchell, Elstrup very nicely conceived this attack. Crisp passing in treacherous conditions. For the moment, Feyenoord seem to have a second win. Element. Monco couldn't get there. Lenkeek away from Beinstakers. Element waiting in the middle. Canel's cross. Van der Berg wanted too long. De Jong was trying to prevent the corner as the ball looped away, but the linesman said it had gone behind. It looks as though Feyenoord have changed their policy. Sparta are changing their personnel with Edwin Vurens coming on for Berkling, but Beinstakers seems to have relinquished his man-for-man marking on Element. Older Riekerink. Riederhof. Now, can Hoekstra get away here? He can. Feyenoord can clinch it. And still can with Hoekstra. Van der Berg blocked it incredibly with the back of his heel. He had two chances, Hoekstra. The first time the goalkeeper held him up, and the second time when the goal really was gaping, Van der Berg got back. It stays at 1-0 to Feyenoord. Now, Element and Moncal. Thrills and spills in the Rotterdam derby, which is coming to a splendid climax as Feyenoord here hang on. Out in the right place again. Hoekstra going in too strongly on Riederhof. The free kick already taken. But Feyenoord have had their opportunities to kill this game off, and there might be another one arriving. Heus. Well played. Padded up by Furen. Riederhof. The crowd want the ball to go forward, but he sensibly kept possession. Older Riekerink. Furen. Got the run of the ball against Elstrup. Van Stay. And they are getting closer and closer. It was a great cross on the run. And Ellerman and Lenkek both going for it. It came off Lenkek's head. Some errors creeping in. Very sapping conditions for the players. Mitchell. Here's Dave Mitchell again, who of course played in Scotland before going to Germany. Buren. Oh, the Rikerink has gone outside him. Ellerman! Right at the last. Now De Jong stayed on his line here. The cross was deflected from 6 yards. Ellerman heads into the roof of the net. Feyenoord with a point snatch from them, or can they bounce back? Ellerman, 8 goals now in 7 games. How long will Sparta be able to hang on to his talent? And that save on the line from Van der Berg, and Mitchell's near misses thrown into sharper relief now. A point apiece, and really justice in the end. An excellent match.
Well, Benny, hi.
Hi.
A new talent in Holland. I thought you had a difficult match against Benny Wijnstekers and Sjaak Troost in the beginning.
Yes, he played very well against me, and very short. It was difficult for me today, but I scored a goal. 1-1. Yeah.
You could explain
nice.
That, eh? When you are becoming a star, then everyone is going tougher and tougher playing against you.
Yes, they know who I am, I scored 7 goals, so they look to me,
Then you have to be
difficult.
A real star to score a goal like this,
yes,
at the end of the match.
Yes, I had a few minutes.
What was happening with that goal? The ball came from
Jan van der Rikerink.
Yeah?
Jan van der Rikerink, a pass off from the right side, a header. So
a beautiful header.
Yes.
So what's going on now with Sparta? What will be happening? Because you are staying on top.
Yes, we are in front of the competition, and we hope we stay there to the third, fourth place.
And your own future?
Yeah, I don't know.
Your contract with Sparta, how many years?
Yes, 2 years. But
2 years, from now?
Yeah, from now.
So you think you stay in Sparta or going to Milan?
I hope so, but...
Do you hope?
Yes.
Okay. Hey, thank you. It was a great match, and see you.
Okay,
at Sky Channel very soon, I think, because we are following you. And all the fans, they are waiting for you. Okay, Jules.
We'll be back with more Dutch football.
The story of Sparta part 2, the story of winnen to Jukes. A scalp again?
Well, half a scalp today. Hey. We've got the half a scalp. I thought it was a tremendous game for the crowd. I'm glad I haven't got a pacemaker, because I think I'd have been dead now. But it was a game that I thought we played in the second half better for football, and there were chances from both sides, and we missed them, and they missed. And I think that this is the football you've got to play at home. What I promised before the start of the season, we're going to make a spectacle here and try and get the crowds back. And I think that everybody went home and seen a good yeah. game.
Even when it was raining, terrible.
Well, yeah, that's I noticed that nobody was moving. They were waiting and looking. And you could see we were going to equalise, you know. And the point was when. We had to take an awful lot of risks back. And I've got to give a compliment
to
Weinberg. You know, Weinberg played brilliant one against one. And Ronnie van den Berg, he pushed in and then... It was a great goal from Jules again.
What about Pieter Kamps? Not an easy match for him.
No, well, it was difficult because we went one against one at the back and we didn't have any cover, and it's difficult with Pieter isn't the quickest, you know, and Pete Weinberg is quick, so we turned the role a bit, you know. Yeah. But it was a bit difficult for Pete, but that's the risk when you're losing 1-0. You've got to try to...
He was working, eh?
Oh, he's working very well. I mean, they've all worked again tremendously, and they believe that they could come back. And very strangely, Fine had panicked at the back, and I thought it was unnecessary, really.
The panic was unbelievable.
Well, he changed. He said something to Weinsteiger to go away from Jules Elleman and to go in the midfield and let Monk out. I thought that was a mistake because Benny didn't know where he had to go, and he stayed as well, and that brought us more in the midfield.
I think that was the problem with the goal from Jules Elleman, because first Jacques Troost, then Benny Weinsteiger.
That's right.
And then no one.
It was undecided. Nobody knew who should get him, and he just, you know, the way Jules is, he just gets in and he gets a nick.
So a real star.
Well, if you keep scoring goals like this, important goals, and you're a crowd pleaser, and you make the equaliser, I mean, everybody's talking about him, and it's not only him, of course, it's
the team.
And we had to change it about at half time a bit, and they did very, very well. I'm very, very pleased.
Let's go back to the first half. You were arguing with Rinus Israel from Feyenoord.
No, well, Rinus was complaining about he should have had a penalty. Well, we should have had a penalty before that. And he was, you know, the way Rinus is, he was complaining, saying, oh, he should have asked. Well, what about the one we should have had? And he's going like this. But, you know, it's all part of the show and the game. And he's the boy that knows the game, Rinus. And he knows that you're going to come back. And we play towards this side always well, you know.
What about the referee, Jan Keizer? He's back.
Well, Jan, you know, Jan makes his mistakes and he does good things. And one thing I'd appreciate today, he let the game flow. He let the game flow. There were little infringements where he let it go, and he just said, come on, it's a derby game. There's going to be a few things that I could say will stop. But he kept the game going. And then the
public is the winner. Eh?
And then the crowd enjoyed it very much. You don't want to see a referee, you know, and he kept it going. And you've got to give him a compliment for that.
What's the next game?
We're playing against Willem II away on Saturday night, and we're still second place, I think, and I don't know what the other teams have done. We've got a good goal average.
And you're waiting for PSV now.
Well, if we can get the third scalp, then I'll be the big engine chief of Sparta, won't I?
Yeah, and you have to sing half a song now, eh?
Yeah, well, I'll sing another time, not on a Sky channel.
After PSV.
After PSV, we'll sing a song.
Okay, thank you, Barry, nice and I see you.
Thank you.
Goodbye. You.